Well, I'm going to show a greedy algorithm here for finding the shortest path between new nodes to two nodes in a graph, start S and terminate T, with Dijkstra's algorithm. And I've written up the algorithm in pseudocode up here to start with, and what I'm going to do is step through that pseudocode first, and then I'm going to talk generally about what it is trying to implement. So let us imagine I have this graph here. Let's start with something nice and simple. So I have, S. Let's change colors so that we can see it. S goes to A and to B. And then both A and B go to my terminal node that I'm looking for. Distance from S to A is 1, S to B is 2, A to T is 10, and B to T is 1 to make it easy. Here's our weight matrix right here. So S, A, B, T. Okay, so S to A is 1, S to B is 2, A to T is 10, B to T is 1, and T has no children. Okay, let us start exercising this algorithm. So I'll just keep track of we'll do it right. Here's the known set. We're going to start with our known set just having the start node in it. And the idea of the known set is that these will be the nodes that we have visited that we've found the shortest path from this set right here, from the start node to the elements of this set right here. So when we begin, we know the shortest path from the start node S to the node S, which is, of course, 0. Then we want to initialize this data structure, DIST, of the different vertexes. So our vertexes are S, A, B, T. Okay, and we start out with all of our vertexes being infinity, initialized there. And then our next part of initialization is for every edge that goes from S to another vertex, we initialize that vertex to be the weight. So here, S goes to A, I know that, so the weight in my DST array will be that 1, and S goes to B, so my weight in my DST array will be that 2. Okay, now we proceed to executing the algorithm. Last is given the value S. That'll be the last node that I visited right there. And I'm going to enter this while loop. That'll go from there to there. I choose V1, the vector that is not in my known, the vertex that is not in my known set that minimizes my distance. So in my known set is S, so I'm not going to be considering that S, because that's not, S is in my known set. So I've got 1, 2, infinity, so I will choose A. So my V1 is A. Okay, for each edge from A to another vertex, I calculate the new distance. So I'm going to calculate a new distance for B here in my DIST matrix and T in my DIST matrix. Okay, so DIST X, that'll be DIST, the first one is B, will equal the min of these two things, the distance that's already in there, in this DIST array, to B, and that is 2, or the distance to my selected vertex, which is A, so that's 1, plus the distance from A to my unknown vertex B. So the distance from A to B, that's infinity. So I have infinity right here. So that equals 2. So the distance to B is 2. So this is going to change to 2. And of course, I haven't added any new information there. Okay. I need to do that for every edge. So my next DIST I have to look at will be T, and that'll be the minimum of, so my X is T here, the distance to the dist of T is infinity, versus the dist A, the dist A is 1, plus the weight from A to T. From A to T is 10. So that gives me 11. So the new dist T is 11. Okay, so what this tells us is, at this point, I know I've got a shortest path from S to A, which has weight 1, from S to B, which has weight 2, and I know a shortest path from S to T, which has weight 11. That is, I know this path, I know this path, and I know this path right here. I do not yet know this path here. Okay, my next step, let's see, I've got last equals V1, so last changes to A, and my known is my known union A. Right, so now I've got these two nodes taken care of. Okay, so that takes care of that first iteration of that while loop. Next iteration of that while loop, I have to choose, because last does not equal T, right? It's A, not T. So I need to choose an unknown vertex that minimizes this. So I've got A is known, S is known, so I've got B or T. B is what minimizes it. So I'll choose my V1. Is going to be B. So now I'm calculating every edge that comes, right, every edge from B to all the other vertexes, so really it's only X equals T. So the distance to T now is the min of the distance to T, which was 11. That's the former best path that I had, versus the distance to B, which is 2, plus the weight between B and T. Between B and T, I have 1. So that equals 3. So the minimum of 11 and 3 is 3, so that's my new distance T. So this goes to now 3. Okay. And I say last equals V1, so last now goes to B. And known goes to known union B. So I'm done with that. Okay, so my last is now B, right? I need to select the unknown vertex minimizing distance, and the only unknown vertex is T, so I'm going to choose T. So V1 is T. I should draw the line to show my iteration. So I need my distance. So for every edge, I've got T. T goes to every other edge. There's nothing else there. So this is done without accomplishing anything. Last is now V, is now T. Known is known union T. So we had T on there. Loop back up. Last not equal to T, which is fails. So I drop out of the loop and I'm done.